Hey guys, I'm at Campbell Cemetery in Billstown, Arkansas. This is a cemetery, obviously, mostly for the Campbell family. But I'm after one specific Campbell. And that is the country singer, guitarist, Glen Campbell. He was born here in Billstown, Arkansas on April 22nd, 1936. And he died in Nashville, Tennessee on August 8th, 2017. After dealing with Alzheimer's for quite a while, he kind of is known for bringing country music to the mainstreams, and was kind of had some crossover hits with Rhinestone Cowboy, Wichita Lineman, and Southern Nights. He won Grammy Awards in both pop and country the categories. His career spanned about six decades. He sold about 50 million records. And so he really left kind of his mark on the culture as a musician, singer, actor, and television personality. Like I said, you can see there's a lot of Campbell family here. Glen, he really began his professional career playing as a guitarist for Elvis Presley. And Frank Sinatra, the Beach Boys, and others. And he had a band called The Wrecking Crew. He then spent decades on the charts as a solo artist, and he was a recipient of, like I said, numerous awards. There's like 10 Grammy Awards, 11 Academy of Country Music Awards, 3 Music Awards, 3 Country Music Awards, 3 Gospel Music Associations, and he was inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame in 2005, and the Musicians Hall of Fame in 2007. He had reached the he received the Grammy Lifetime Achievement Award in 2012, and he got some Arkansas Country Music Awards in 2008. And as you can see, here's his grave again, April 22nd, 1936, died April 8th, 2017. Psalms 23. His wife, Kimberly Woolen, who's not passed away yet, born June 18th, 1958. And you can see that. It looks like they were united in marriage. I don't know if you can see that. 1982. Lots of stones left here on his grave. A shell. Lots of shells, probably from the Beach Boys, maybe, or, you know, from his time with the Beach Boys, maybe, I'm thinking. Guitar pick there. Lots of flowers still. Like I say, I'm going to assume almost all these are family, possibly brothers and sisters, or cousins. Oops. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, at least seven, eight. Eight Campbell graves, just that little area alone. We'll just walk the rest of the cemetery since we're here. The only Glen Campbell song I know, honestly, is Rhinestone Cowboy. Like I said, I was never I've said it before, I've never been a huge country fan. There's a stone right there in the fallen tree there. A couple more Campbells over here. Again, I don't know the significance. I don't know who they are. I shouldn't say significance, that sounds kind of poor taste. Another Campbell. Driving up, I thought that was a Campbell Grave originally, just because of the guitar on it. William Boo, Shirley Woodley, Shirley. Mark Campbell. And we'll just walk to the end of the cemetery here and turn back around and back up at Glenn's grave here. Maybe about 24 graves marked at least out here. There could be others unmarked. Some more Campbells, Mary. I've seen a few woods here already. Nelson, Paget. Yeah, so maybe 24 cemetery or 24 stones. That's about it. I'm gonna say half of them are Campbells. I could learn how to fix the camera. So we'll end back up, like I said, at the Glen's grave and call it a day. Those people are probably going there too. So we'll end it here. Like I say, we've seen everything. Well, I said I was done. Old boy pulled up here at the Campbell Cemetery and got out of the car and started chatting with me. And it was J.W. Campbell. It was Glen Campbell's baby brother. 89-year-old baby brother. So I got chatting with him a little bit, and he was telling me, you know, some of the folks here in the cemetery talking about Glenn and how he went on tour with Glen Campbell, worked with him for about 8 years, and just kind of more or less the private stuff of Glen Campbell, how he kind of, you know, didn't let anything go to his head and came back home and put some bathrooms in some of the buildings here in town that, you know, didn't have facilities in the buildings that were out, you know, still outhouses, and how he really helped everybody in his family and helped all of his old friends and neighbors. And he was telling me this is the Campbell Cemetery because Glenn had put this together for all of his family way back when. And all these stones here in this general area here. The one over here, that was his folks. Of course, I'm talking to JW, of course, his brother, his folks. That was a sister. You know, this is a, you know, brother, another brother. So it was really cool. I mean, kind of meeting Glen Campbell's brother and him kind of sharing everything with me. So kind of neat little experience. I wasn't planning on being here that long, and I learned a lot more about Glenn than I ever imagined I would. Really cool. Guy was 90 years old, and he was I never would have guessed it. The guy was in amazing shape, better than more shape than I am. But I'll end it here. Here's the grave of Glen Campbell.